Yes. Good morning, dear students. We'll move on to the chapter electric potential and capacitors. The electric potential at a point x, y, z is given by V is equal to minus x square y minus x cube x z cube plus 4. The electric field at that point is given by. Now you know very well that electric field is nothing but E is equal to generally, okay, minus del V by or dV by, you know, dr, general one, okay, yeah. But here you have got the coordinates of x, y as well as z here, is it right? So therefore, what I have to do is nothing but, my dear students, E is equal to, okay, I have to do minus, okay, del V divided by del x, all right, okay. Then I have to do, that is gives you the x component for you. Then E is equal to minus del V by del Y. Yeah. Then E is equal to, of course, minus del V divided by del Z. Yes. All right. So what is this E is equal to? I'll do it only for one here. Let's see if I find. X square Y you find. So you know that here you're differentiating with respect to X, Y will be a constant there. So x square, when you differentiate, it is nothing but 2x, you're fine. Okay, yeah. So your answer is nothing but 2x, that is minus sign is there. So minus, okay, this is of the formula. Then minus 2xy, which is nothing but plus 2xy. That's the first part. Okay, yeah. Second part, I'll do that anyway. You got then, okay, one more thing is there with the expression, one more thing is there, okay, not only this part, second term is there, x z cube minus, okay, you know that z cube is a constant, you find z cube is a constant there, differentiate x, so what you'll get is nothing but minus of that, you find that will be nothing but plus z cube. Okay, I hope you are clear with this one, plus z cube. So this is one thing. So 2xy plus z cube is with respect to x. With respect to y, okay, with respect to y, what you've got is nothing but simply you have got minus x square is there, all right, is equal to minus of minus x square is there, differentiation of y will give you 1, all right, so this will be nothing but plus x square, all right. Then as far as z is considered there, you know that here minus sign of minus, okay, minus x z cube here, x as it is there, z cube is nothing but 3z square, which is nothing but 3z square x. All right. Now, when you observe this one, I think this is related to your z cap, k cap here. All right. Okay. This is related to your j cap. All right. Okay. And this is related to I cap. So therefore, my dear students, what's my answer? My answer, which is having I cap, j cap, as well as k cap, I have to look for it. Yeah, which is nothing but this is option number 2 is the right answer. 2xy minus z cube, this is minus sign, okay, yeah. Minus z cube plus j cap plus x square, correct, yeah, fine. Then 3z square x, that's fine, k cap, you're fine. That is nothing but option number 2. My dear students, don't worry about this question, you're fine. Tomorrow in the exam, any function they might give you, yeah. Are you understanding that? If at all it contains only x, then you have to differentiate with respect to x only. That's why electric field is along the x-axis. But if at all it has got a terms containing x, y, z, then you have to do separately for delta V by delta x, minus delta V by delta y, minus delta V by delta z. That's a simple thing, but here you will not find any difficulty because you have done much more difficult differentiation problems. It just requires differentiation of this logic and that should give you the answer. Okay. Now, a simple problem. I hope you'll be able to understand it easily there. Okay. Yeah. Let me move on to the next problem. A positively charged body A has been brought, say, look at this. This is a positively charged body A, has been brought near the brass cylinder B. This is nothing but the brass cylinder B, mounted on a glass stand. And this is nothing but insulating stand, my dear students. Insulating stand, or which is non-conducting stand. The potential of B will be. Now, what happens to the potential of B? If you look into it, your question will be nothing but, okay, So a positively charged body A has been brought near the brass cylinder B, mounted on a glass stand as shown in the figure. The potential of B will be. Okay. Simply your answer is nothing but zero here. Why that potential of B is zero? You must remember that it is a body which has not excess of charges, either positive or negative. Therefore, the potential of B will be zero. That's what you get it. Okay. Yeah. Let me see that in the chat box. What are the answers are there? Yes, Kishan Rao, you're right. The answer is correct. Option number one is the right answer, which is nothing but zero. Let me go into the next question. Electric potential at the surface of the atomic nucleus Z is equal to 50 of radius 9 into 10 per minus 15 meters. Okay, this is a simple logic, my dear students. I know that V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R in the case of the spherical nucleus, you must remember. But who is creating the electric field here? There it's a nucleus, right? So what is the charge of the nucleus? All of you definitely know that charge of the nucleus is nothing but Ze. Charge of the nucleus is nothing but Ze. All right, okay. Once we are sure about the charge of the nucleus is Ze, then we'll have to put that value of Ze and we should get the answer, okay? So understand that this value is equal to Ze. Yeah, why? Charge of the nucleus is equal to Z. Z is the number of protons. E is the charge of the proton, if I'm Ze. Then what is my substitution here, if you ask me? Yeah. Actually, your work should start from here. Not writing the formula, nothing. Simply, potential is nothing but 9 into 10 power 9. Done? Yeah. So that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon. Q is nothing but Ze, 50. E is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, 10 power minus 19, divided by the radius of that nucleus is nothing but 9 into 10 to the power minus 15. Yeah. If at all you manage this particular calculation, then what's my answer? I can get it very easily. Okay. And my dear students, your answer is nothing but option number 2. It is 8 into 10 power 6 volt. You find 8 into 10 power 6 volt is my answer. 8 into 10 to the power 6 volt is the answer. 8 into 10 power 6 volt is the right answer. Okay, yes. So just note down this particular formula, my dear students, and your answer is nothing but so much of volt, which is that option number 2 is the right answer. So electric potential. So how do I get the calculations done faster? Simply must remember 9 and 9 gets cancelled. Look at that. Numerator as well as denominator, 9 and 9 gets cancelled. Right? Okay. Then 15 to 1.6. Immediately you would realize that, okay, 16 fives are, it is. I know it very well, which is nothing but 80. Fine, okay, so this is nothing but 80. Okay, and this part is nothing but 80. Once I know 15 to 1.6 is nothing but 80, all right? Once I know this part is 80, then power of 10 you have to manage. What are the power of 10? Power of 10 is nothing but 10 power 9, all right? 10 power 9 is there. 10 power minus 19 is there, which will give me 10 to the power minus 10. This 10 power minus 15 goes up. That will give you 10 power plus 15. Plus 15 and 10 power minus 10 is 10 power 5. So 80 into 10 power 5 is as good as 8 into 10 power 6 is the right answer. You get it very easily, my dear students. Okay, yeah. Let's proceed into the next question. Okay, next question. A hollow metal sphere. Hollow metal sphere of radius 5 centimeter is charged such that the potential on its surface is 10 volt. The potential at the center of the sphere is, okay, simply your answer is nothing but 10 volt, my dear students. Why is that? you know very well that you studied this particular theory also. What is that theory says? Theory says that electric potential in the case of the sphere, okay, it's an equipotential surface. That's why anywhere inside the sphere, okay, anywhere inside the sphere, anywhere inside the sphere, if you ask me, the potential will become, how much tell me, potential will become zero. Potential will become zero is that, okay, sorry, potential will be the same as that of that. But what about the electric field here? Electric field, okay, inside the charged sphere is equal to zero. That you studied and you derived also. But here in this particular case, if you ask me, all right, you will find that this answer will be same as that on the surface. So what is the value on the surface there? Surface is nothing but 10 volt. Anywhere, please remember, anywhere inside, the value will remain the same. Anywhere, need not be only center. Anywhere, if you ask me, 10 volt is the answer. So that's my option number two, dear students. Let's proceed for the next question. Equal charges Q are placed at the three corners of a square ABCD of side A. The potential at A is. Now let me see how this particular problem goes here. This problem is this way. Let me put it. So we have got a square whose side is nothing but A, and there are charges are placed at the three corners. The charges are placed at the three corners. Let me put it here. Charges are placed at the three corners. Charges are placed at the three corners. Charges are placed So let me take that. Okay, the charges are placed at the three corners of ABCD square. Can you have been asked to find out what is the potential at A? Now we have got a system here having three charges out of the four corners. Okay, yeah. A, B, C, and D. Has been placed at this corner, which is nothing but ABCD. In all these corners, there is a charge Q is placed. Here also there is a charge Q is placed, and this is Q is placed. All right, and the distance for this one is A. Okay, for distance for this charge is also A, and distance for this charge is simple. That is nothing but root 2 into A. Yes. Now, what about the answer? How do I get this answer? What is the electric potential? Remember, geometry might be different, but logic, if you understand it, because we can't go on, you know, answering for all the geometry there. Let me just tell you the answer. Potential at A, okay, which is nothing but VA, I'm going to write, is equal to, VA is equal to, VA is equal to
minus.
Is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is common for all the charges. 4 pi epsilon is common. Q is common for all the charges because charges are one and the same. Okay, yes. Divided by, okay, into, you must remember, into into one divided by A, there's the first part of it, plus 1 divided, that's Q divided by A, all right, okay, A plus 1 divided by, okay, root 2A is that, okay, yes, and here also I'm getting the same thing, okay. All right, so VA is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by A plus 1 by A plus root 2A. Yeah. Then I have to find out the answer. Please, dear students, I want you to do the calculation. Your answer is nothing but option number 3 is the right answer. Option number 3 is the right answer. So Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught A. A is common. I can just take it outside. Okay, so it is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by A. Okay, into 1 plus 1 is nothing but 2 plus 1 by root 2. Yes. So that you can do it. And your answer is nothing but option number 3 is the right answer, dear students. Okay. Let me move on to the next question. Question number 5. Here. 6 right now. In the electric field of the point charge Q, a certain charge is carried from the point A to B, C to D. And A to B, C, D, and E, the work done is least among what path, zero, all those things here. Fine. Okay, let me see right now here. In the electric field of a point charge Q, look at this. This is nothing but the point charge Q. Yeah. Which is situated at the center of the circular, circular shape. What is the work done in carrying the point charge? Okay, certain charge. A to B, C, D, and E, the work done is. So you know the answer. Answer is nothing but option number 3 is the right answer. 0 along any path. Why 0 along any path? Remember, you asked me from B to C. Yeah. Equipotential surface. If the potential here is 50 volt, what's the potential here? 50 volt. 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 Because all of them are lying on the surface of the equipotential body. Yeah, then. Anywhere to anywhere you ask me, what is the work done in carrying a charge? Answer is 0 because we know the formula, work done is equal to charge multiplied by potential difference between the two points where you're taking the charge. Okay, so answer is option number 3 is the right answer, dear students there. Okay, yeah. Let me proceed into the question number 7. Yeah. The work done in moving an electron of charge E and mass M from A to B in the circular paths, okay, shown by the arrow mark. You find shown by the arrow mark. All right. Okay. In the vertical plane of the field charge Q is. I don't think I need to answer your question there. Okay. How do I go for it? The work done in moving an electron of charge E of mass m be along the circular path as shown by a vertical plane in the field of charge Q is. How is that? Let me tell you. It's important that you are taking in the vertical plane electron. Electron has got mass. Remember that. This is what you should not forget it. Okay, yeah. Electron has a mass. Yes. All right. What is the work done in the electric field, if you ask me? Work done in the electric field is equal to zero, no doubt about it. Yeah, but that should not be answer zero for you. Remember that. Okay, but definitely you must remember, we have taken a body, say having mass m, that's why electron's mass has been given to you, and that has been taken to this point, and this is where exactly your charge q is there, and you move from here to here. Is it right? You're fine. You've got gravitational work is there. Gravitational potential energy is changing. Yeah, how much is the distance? Yeah, distance is nothing but 2r. Yeah, you might have gone like this one. I know it. Okay, yes. But your displacement is nothing but 2r. Therefore, how much is the work done, if you ask me? Work done is equal to mg, okay, into r. Mg into r, my dear students. Okay, what is the distance r here? It is nothing but 2r. Therefore, your answer is nothing but option number 1, which is nothing but 2mgr is the right answer. 2mgr is the right answer, dear students. Okay, yes. I hope you are clear. So work done in the electric field of charge plus Q, if you ask me, that is zero, no doubt about it. But it has got a mass. That's why when you take the electron from one point to the other, some work done has to be done, which is nothing but mg into 2r. Take care of this one. Okay, otherwise, you may write the answer as zero. You're fine. Just by referring to the world question there. Okay. Let's proceed into the next one. Number 8. In a cathode ray tube, if V is the potential difference between the cathode as well as the anode, the speed of the electron when they reach the anode is proportional to. Do remember, we have studied in the chapter electric potential. If a charge having a charge Q, accelerated by a potential difference V, then kinetic energy gained by the charged particle, just based on the work of energy theorem, we got it as K is equal to QV we'll get. And we know very well, half mv square can be replaced for kinetic energy. Is it right? K is equal to Q into capital V. You're asking me how the speed is related to the potential. It's a simple logic there. Half m is a constant, charge is a constant. V square is proportional to capital V. Remember, where capital V is a potential difference. So V is proportional to root V. Therefore, your answer is option number 3. Eighth one, option number 3 is the right answer. So understand the basic logic. When a charge Q is accelerated by a potential difference of capital V, then kinetic energy gained by the particle is given by K is equal to QV. Half m square is the kinetic energy, which is equal to QV. So V square is proportional to capital V, and V is proportional to root V, where option number 3 is the right answer for me. Yeah. So understandable, everybody. Easily you can do it. Okay. This problem has to be done mentally, not writing anything on the paper. Let me go to the question number 9. Okay. Yeah. So understand this problem. Okay, otherwise, it might be a little difficult. Two thin rings, each having radius capital R, are placed at a distance apart with their axis coinciding. The charge on the two rings are plus Q and minus Q respectively. The potential difference between the centers of the rings is. Okay. Now understand this problem. How is this problem? Okay, so diagram might be required. Okay, some of you can do without the diagram, but I just want you to know this. Concentrate here, otherwise you may not understand this. This is one thin ring. at a distance d. All right, there is one more ring is there. Yes, it said very clearly this ring has got a radius r. What about the other ring? Other ring also has got a radius r, no doubt about it. But so this ring has got a charge q, and this ring has got a charge minus q. Yeah, all right. Okay. Now, question, the potential difference between the centers of the two rings is, that implies, let me take that, this is the point A, this is the point B. What I want to find out, I have to find out VA, and I have to find out VB, then I have to find out VA minus VB. That implies, first you have to find out the potential at A, then you find the potential at B, then you have to find out the difference between the two. Sir, what is the potential at A, if you ask me? Potential at A, let me tell you, okay, all of you please see here. One is the charge due to it. What is the charge due to it? Which is nothing but, okay, K. K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon, let it be there. Q divided by R, that is due to the charge present over here, my dear students. Is that clear? Oh. Then, definitely this charge is there, no, on that ring you're fine, okay? And this will be at a distance of, try to understand my dear students, from here, okay, at a distance of r square plus d square. These are the charges located at these points here, okay, on the rings. Then what is the charge there? Plus, or the potential there? Q into, okay, minus q, which is at a distance of root of r square plus d square. Agree? Yes, done. Now come to the potential at B. One potential comes because of its own, you find. That is nothing but K. Okay, one is K. K value. K. Okay, because of its own charge Q divided by R. R. Yes, divided by R. Plus, due to the charge plus Q there, so which is nothing but K Q divided by root of R square plus D square. Yeah. So I've understood this value of VA. I've understood the value of VB. Fine. But the question is not to find out the potential at A and potential at B. You've been asked to find out the potential difference between the centers of the two rings. Has been asked. You find. Okay. That implies. What you have to do is nothing but you have to do VA minus VB. VA minus VB, you have to do it. Okay, yeah. You have to do VA minus VB. Okay, try to understand, my dear students. Okay, don't think that terms will be getting cancelled. They look like they are getting cancelled, but this is minus KQ by R. This is KQ by R. So KQ by R minus or minus KQ by R is equal to, if you are able to manage it well and good, otherwise you have to spend a lot of time, 2KQ divided by capital R. I hope you're clear. This is with the plus term. This is the minus term. So this one, minus of minus, that will become plus two times. Okay, yes. Then, what will get about this one? That's also, this is minus, and this is minus. So it is minus 2KQ divided by root of R square plus D square. Okay, yeah, that's my next step. You can have a in-between step, but that is not advisable. You will be slow if you are doing it. Okay. Now, once you are knowing this one, I have to find out the answer. You know very well, K is what? K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay. Then write that, and common ones, you can take it outside and get the right answer there. Okay, let me just take it up here. What I'm getting here is, K is equal to 2KQ inside the bracket 1 by R minus 1 by root of R square plus D square. Okay, yeah. Now in the place of K, replace it by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So that 2 and 4, 4 gets with 2 here. So what you'll get is nothing but Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught, like that you get. So that's why I think your answer should be option number 2 here. I can have with a step here, if you ask me, 2 into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by R minus 1 by root of R square plus D square. This is what you get. So 2 ones are, 2 twos are here. you get the answer option number two. But are you clear? What I'm trying to tell you is nothing but, is that clear to you? Okay, how to get the answer number two? Yes. Next. Let's proceed to the question number 10. There are two concentric metal shells. Clearly understand. There are two concentric metal shells. Yeah, let me draw that first. This is one shell of radius R1. Yeah. Next is the other cell. Of radius R2, of course, R2 is bigger than R1, no doubt about it. If the outer shell of charge Q and the inner shell is grounded, outer shell has got a charge Q, and the inner shell is grounded, the charge on the inner shell is, okay. Now let me just tell you, I don't know what is the charge on the inner shell. Let me take the charge on the inner shell is nothing but Q1. I don't know, I have to find out. So let me take it as Q1. With that, I will just proceed. Then what should I do? Potential in the inner shell, K. Q1 is the charge on the inner shell divided by the radius of the shell, R1. Plus, potential due to the next shell you find, which is nothing but K, which is Q divided by R2. But do you remember that it's connected to the ground here? Therefore, your answer is nothing but zero. Sum of the potential is equal to zero because the inner shell is connected to the ground. And you must remember, my dear students, your answer is done with this. You find. So what you get is nothing but KQ1 by R1 is equal to minus KQ divided by R2. How about your K and K gets cancelled? So Q1 is equal to minus Q into R1 by R2 into Q. That is your answer, R1 by R2 into Q. Option number 2 is right answer, of course. So it has to be written R1 by R2 into Q. So I hope you are clear with the step. I am not worried about this calculation. This calculation, anybody can do it. Okay. One is the potential. So I was not knowing the charge on the inner shell. So I took it as Q1. So KQ1 by R1, that's the potential of the inner shell plus potential of the outer shell. Okay, these are grounded. That's why net potential is equal to zero. So that's the answer there. So you get the option number 2 is the right answer. Let's proceed into the next question. A charge Q is placed in an uniform electric field E. It is released from rest. Then kinetic energy of the charge after traveling a distance y will be. No. So you have to find out the kinetic energy, okay, after traveling a distance. Do remember, we have studied what is the kinetic energy, work done. Work done is equal to force into displacement. Force due to the electric field into displacement. A simple logic, let me ask you. What is the force? Force is nothing but Q into E. Displacement is Y, and that is nothing but the work done. Remember that work done is equal to change in kinetic energy because it's starting from rest. Therefore, delta K itself is equal to K. Otherwise, I should write delta K is equal to KF minus KI, change in kinetic energy. But change in kinetic energy means Ki is zero. This is, let me take it as K. So that itself is nothing but K. Therefore, don't worry about this kind of the explanation there. You have to know it. Not that, you know, when the initial value is zero, then change in kinetic energy is the value itself, final value itself. So K, which is equal to KEY. Therefore, kinetic energy is given by the formula. So QEY, option number 1 is the right answer, my dear students. The body is released from rest. Charge particle is released from rest. Kinetic energy of the charge after traveling distance y will be. Okay. This is what exactly we have to take care of. Simple. Work done is nothing but force due to the electric field multiplied by displacement. Force due to the electric field is QE into Y. Work done is nothing but change in kinetic energy. KF minus KI. But initial kinetic energy is zero because your charge particle is starting from rest. Therefore, kinetic energy is K, is equal to QE, Y is the right answer. Okay. Common question, easily manageable. Okay. 8 equal charge tiny drops are combined to form a big drop. If the potential on each drop is 10 volt, the potential on the big drop is. Okay. There are plenty of the formula out there, my dear students. I would like to take it here. One of the formula is nothing but potential of the bigger drop. Everything are given in your booklet. Please read them. N to the power 2 by 3 into potential of the smaller drop. Like that is a formula for capacitance. Capacitance of the bigger drop is equal to N to the power 1 by 3 into capacitance of the smaller drop. Radius of the bigger drop when the drops are combining is equal to N to the power 1 by 3 into radius of the smaller drop. Like that the questions will, formulas are there. Okay, read it and know them. If you know it, then the problem is very simple. How many drops are combined here? 8 equal drops are combined. Okay, so 8 to the power 2 by 3 into smaller drop has got potential of 10 volt. But 8, I have written like that, but don't write 8 as 8. I wish that you write 2 cube to the power 2 by 3 into 10. So what about your 3 and 3 gets cancelled? 2 square is nothing but 4. 4 into 10 is nothing but 40 volt is right answer. Option number 1 is right. Okay, but important for me is this formula. You know it? Yes. There's a classical method of doing it, but don't go by that. It will be really taking so much of time from your side. So finish it off. That's your answer there. 40 volt is right answer. Okay, agreeable. Next one, 13th question. Identical charges minus Q are placed at each corner of a cube of side B. The electrostatic potential of the charge plus Q, which is placed at the center of the cube, will be. Right. Okay. Now, it's a simple logic that you have to understand about cube. Okay, suppose if at all you've got a cube here. Okay, the diagram may not be perfectly all right, but I'll try to give you this. Every corner of the cube has been filled with, okay, let it be like that. Yeah, okay. Now, this is the center of the cube. I hope you are understanding that. It is not center of the surface which is available to you, center of the cube. And that distance, if you ask me, I hope you are clear. It's a three-dimensional diagram there, center of the cube. That distance, if you ask me, okay, please remember, it is root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2. Into the side is nothing but B. I'm not talking about a surface which is visible to you. Okay, either Lanodi. This is the surface which is visible to you. Adu central. I hope you are clear. It's the center of the cube. Therefore, from the corner to the center of the cube, I hope you understood that diagram. Yeah, then the distance is nothing but root 3 by 2 into B. Remember, how do I do that? You can use Pythagoras theorem and get it here. Yeah? But at this point, we are not spending time on doing it. Remember the value from the corner to the center of the cube. Root 3 by 2 into side. Whatever the symbol you give for the side. It may be A, B or anything. Yeah. You're asking me electrostatic potential energy of the charge plus Q placed at the center. What are the charges which are placed at every corner? Which is nothing but minus Q. How many corners are there? 8 corners are there. And what should I do here? Fine. My answer is, okay, 8. Why into 8? 8 into, because 8 such corners are there. 1 by, okay. What is the formula for system of two charges, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R. Such for 8 sets are there. That's why 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Charge at the center is Q and charge at the corner is minus Q divided by the distance between the points, whatever you're talking about it, which is root 3 by 2 B. Over. All over. And that's why if this diagram, if at all you have been doing and practicing it, then you can do it without drawing the diagram because you know it's very simple. Whatever the work I'm doing once, I have to multiply by 8 times. So that's how exactly we go for it. So when you are doing this one, your answer should be, okay. Yeah. 2 will come here up, that will become 16. 16 by 4 is nothing but 6. 16 by 4 is nothing but 4. Yeah, that is there. And you got Q square, no doubt about it, divided by. Okay, Q square is there, divided by what's left out there. Okay. This is gone here. Root 3 is pending. Root 3 pi epsilon naught is there as well as B is there. root 3 pi epsilon b. Of course, no, you cannot forget that minus sign. So minus 4 q square divided by root 3 pi epsilon naught b. Is it right? So that will be your option number 3 is the right answer, dear students. Okay, option number 3. Minus 4 q square divided by root 3 pi epsilon b. Option number 3 is the right answer. Yes. I hope you are clear. Just you have to remember this formula. Potential energy of two charge system. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r. But you have to multiply by 8 times because 8 such pairs are there. That's the reason. Okay. So that's why I come here. All right. And get this answer done. One thing that you have to remember is the geometry which you might have learned in 9th standard or so. Distance from the corner of the cube to the center is nothing but root 3 by 2 into the side. Two charges Q1 as well as Q2. Q1 you can see here, Q2 you can see, are placed 30 centimeter apart. This is 30 centimeter apart, as shown in the figure. A third charge Q3 is moved along the arc of the circle of radius 40 centimeter, okay, from C to D. This is moving from C to D. The change in potential energy system is Q cube divided by 4 pi epsilon into K, where K is. Okay. Now the problem, we have to do it. Okay, so it might take little time. Let us do that. No problem at all. There are in the beginning, what was the potential energy? Then later, what was the potential energy? When this charge Q3 is at C, okay, this charge Q3 is at C, no? What is the potential energy? Then get that charge Q3 at D. Then what is the potential energy? Then we have to get the answer. Now, please see, when Q3 is at C, yes, Q3 is at C. Let me tell you. First charge system is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1 and Q3, you just take it out. V1, let me take that. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, which is common. Okay, Q1 and Q3 are the two charges. Q3 are the two charges. Gap between them is 40 centimeter. Let me write 40 only. No problem at all. Not 0.4, whatever. Plus, okay, there is a charge B is there, charge at B is there, Q2, and this distance is very much important, and I don't think I should tell you this distance. This distance is nothing but 0.5 meter. Do you know Avogadro, Pythagoras theorem? Yeah. So, plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, which you need not repeat, but I am doing little classically, Q2, Q3 divided by 0.5. This is my V1, dear students. All right. But still one more is pending there. What is that you find? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Three charge system is that. Is it right? Q1, Q3, Q2, Q3. Then you have to get one more. Q1, Q2 is there. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1, Q2. The gap between the two is nothing but 0.3. Yes. This is my V1, my dear students. Okay. Yeah. What is potential energy, sorry, this is potential energy U1. Potential energy in the second case, U2. In this case, U2, please remember your Q3 has come here at this spot now. Okay, yeah. Then what about the two charge system you find? Same way, but distances might change. That's it. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1 and Q3 are at a distance of. How much distance? BD. BD is nothing but 40 centimeter arc here, right? So Q1, Q3 are at a distance of 0.4 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay. Q2, Q3, Q2, Q3, they are at a distance of, say, from here to here 40, this is 30, this is 30. So what does that tell me? 0.1 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2 is there. They are at a distance of 0.3, okay, which is not going to change. Yeah. Then what I have to do is I have to do delta U. So delta U is equal to, I hope you will be able to do this one. Okay. Delta U, you'll have to do it. And that answer comes out to be, okay, how much we have to find out. And that I have to equate it to Q cube divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into K. Then you'll get the value of K. Okay. So is that okay for you? So what I have to do is nothing but you have to do U2 minus U1, final potential energy minus initial potential energy. If at all you are doing it, your answer will be, okay, Q3. So this is not Q cube here, Q3. Okay. Q3 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, into 8Q2, you are getting it. Other points are getting cancelled there, okay. Now, according to the question, this should be equal to Q3 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into K. And when you equate it, you will get K is equal to 8Q2 is the answer you are getting. Okay. So, dear students, I have not done this step. I want you to do that particular step and get the right answer. Everybody should be doing this step. Then only you can go into it. Okay. I have skipped it because I don't have much space to show that explanation to you. But definitely you should be able to do it and get the answer. Okay. So first you have to understand how was the location. The first location was this. This was your Q1. This is the location of Q3. This is the location of Q2. Of course, the distance are nothing but this is 0.4. This is 0.3. And this is nothing but 0.5. This is the first location. And that's why I've got this value of U1. Second location is nothing but Q1, Q2, and Q3. The gap here is nothing but 30 centimeter. This gap is 10 centimeter. And accordingly, I've done that. And based on that, I've got U2. So the difference on that. So the problem is not tough, but I must say it will little take a little time of yours to do this one. But one can definitely go for it. It might take about, 90 seconds, but doesn't matter. Because you'll get the answer. That's important. Yeah. Sometimes what will happen is a question is very tough where you are not able to get the answer. Then by trying that will be a waste of time. But this problem definitely you can try and you can get the answer. Let's proceed into the next question. Okay. 4 electric charges plus Q. Minus Q are placed at the corners of a square of side 2L. The electric potential at a point capital A, midway between the two charges plus Q and minus Q is. Okay. So I hope you have done that. This is plus Q and minus Q. 1 minute. Plus Q and plus Q. Yeah. So already I've drawn the diagram. They won't give you the diagram, but you should be knowing that diagram that you have to draw it and get the answer. Okay, just in order to get the things easier, I've already placed the diagram there. There's a charge plus Q, minus Q and minus Q are placed. The side square is nothing but 2L. Yeah, okay. They're asking me electric potential at the point A, midway between the two charges, plus Q and plus Q is. Here you're asking me. Yeah. Let us go point by point here and let's get that. So I'm taking care of this part. Worry about this part. And know the potential. What is this distance? L. So what about the potential here? Potential is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by L. So this job is done. Yeah, all right. Good. Let me do the same job. Fine. Is it at a distance of L between these two? If at all you verify that. Yeah, this is at a distance L. Is it 2 times the same thing? So it is nothing but 2 into that. Agreeable. So I have finished the job of this. I've got a job of this one now. Yeah, all right, okay. And such 2 jobs are there, that's why I can do it once and multiply by 2. So it is plus 2 is there. Why you are doing 2? Because you must remember that such minus Qs are present at the corners. 2 corners are there. So whatever the job you are doing for this minus Q, same job is happening over here. Is that clear? Yeah. Now 2 into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q divided by, okay, the distance right now. Sir, what is the distance here? It's a simple logic here. This is L, this is 2L, it's perpendicular. And what should help me out is nothing but Pythagoras theorem, which is nothing but root of, okay, 1 side square, that is nothing but 4L square, 2L whole square, is it right? 4L square plus L square, which is nothing but root of 5L square which is nothing but root of 5L, dear students. Okay, yeah. So which is nothing but root of 5L. Yeah. Now, having said this much, then I have to get the answer. Okay, 1/4 pi epsilon naught is common. Agree. 2Q is common. Of course, this will come with a minus sign, but I'll take it up. 2Q is common. Apart from that, what I've left is nothing but 1/L is left out. Minus sign is there. Okay, I'll just take it up. Minus sign is there. 2Q is out. Okay, 1/√5L is there. Okay, yeah. Of course, L, I was not knowing about it. No problem. 1/4 pi epsilon naught. 2Q divided by L and 1 - 1/√5. This is what the answer is all about. So that's my option number 3 is the right answer, my dear students. Okay, yeah. So a simple logic there, but don't do it 4 times. Since there is a symmetry is there between plus Q and plus Q. That's why I do it once and multiply by 2. Minus Q once you do it and multiply by 2 and doing the calculations faster. Okay. Having the diagram with you, rough diagram, you draw it and place the charges, then it will give a better picture than without drawing the diagram. And finally, I'm leaving it to you. Okay, if you are doing without the diagram, that's the best thing that can happen. Yeah. Let's proceed into the next question. This is precisely based on your theory. I don't want to go into the answer straight away. With no explanation for me. PE into 1 minus cos theta. See your notes given by your teacher. Definitely, this has been discussed to you. I'm not discussing. It's a straightforward question to you. Work done. 17th question. If we treat the Earth as a conducting sphere of radius 6,400 km, its capacitance would be. Remember, capacitance of the spherical conductor. This is one of the very beautiful formula. Capacitance of spherical conductor. I hope you are very clear about my word. Not spherical capacitor. Spherical conductor is nothing but 4 pi epsilon naught r, where r is the radius of the body. R is the radius of conductor, radius of the conductor. So what is this value, if you ask me? Well, 4 pi epsilon naught is nothing but 1/9 × 10⁻¹. I hope, don't confuse. 1/4 pi epsilon naught is 9 × 10⁻¹. 4 pi epsilon naught is 1/9 into r. What is r? R is nothing but 6,400 km, which I can write it as 6.4 × 10⁶ meters. 6,400 km. Okay. 6.4 × 10⁴ × 10⁶. Okay. Now, so what we get here is nothing but 6.4 divided by 9. Okay. 9. Okay. Into 10⁻³. 10⁻³. So the question is, they're asking just the order. All right. Therefore, you must remember answer is of the order of 1 millifarad. Option number 2 is that. Okay. Yes. Okay, the other answer is microfarad, the other one is millifarad, the one is 1,000 farad, and one is 1 farad. Okay, and that's why I understand that even though entire Earth is involved in storing the charges, the ability of storing the charges will be very less because this is a conducting sphere. That's why, you know, in the case of principle of capacitor, they have used two metal plates. One has been grounded, and that will make sure that the ability of storing charges will be very high. Capacitance of the capacitor will be very high. Okay, not just having a single conductor. So anyway, so your answer is of the order of 10⁻³ farad. Option number 2 is the right answer. 18th question. When two uncharged metal balls of radius 0.09 millimeter each collide, one electron will be transferred between them. The potential difference between them would be, okay. Let me see right now, one electron is transferred between them. The potential difference between them will be, yeah. You need to understand that when they are colliding and one transfer electron is transferred between them, then this charge will become minus E, this fellow's charge will become plus E. Yeah, all right. Now, potential difference is asked. Potential difference is asked means first you have to understand what's the potential of this fellow. Potential of this fellow is V is equal to 1/4 pi epsilon naught. Okay. Q divided by R. That implies 1/4 pi epsilon naught is 9 × 10⁹. 9 × 10⁹. Charge is how much? Electronic charge 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. Yeah. And the radius is nothing but 0.09 millimeter. 0.09 into 10 power minus 3. So this is the potential I have to find out. Okay, how much is that? Let us find out. That's about the 1. Okay, so 9 into 10 power 9, 1.6 into 10 minus 9 divided by 0.09 into 10 power minus 3. Okay, the value will be 1 minute. 9 into 1.6. Yeah, so what I would like you to do is nothing but this you can treat it as 9 into 10 power minus 2. So this will be 9 into 10 power minus 2. Okay, so that 9 and 9 gets cancelled. 10 power minus 2 and 10 power minus 3 is 10 power minus 5. Correct? Yeah. That will come up. That will be 10 power plus 5. That is 10 power 14 and 10 power minus 19. That is nothing but 10 power minus 5. What is pending is nothing but 1.6 into 10 power minus 5 volt. Yeah. Okay. Please don't do this one. This, how much is the potential of that if you ask me? That is nothing but, let me take V1, right? The potential of this one is same, minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 5 volt. Correct. You're asking me the potential difference. What is the potential difference? Delta V is equal to V1 minus V2. That implies 1.6 into 10 power minus 5. Don't spend time in this. Minus of minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 5. So add the two things there, which is nothing but 3.2 into 10 power minus 5, which is nothing but 32 into 10 power minus 6 volt is the right answer. Option number 3 is the right answer, my dear students. 32 microvolt is the right answer. Yeah, all right. Yes. So it's a simple logic that you'd understand. When they collide, one electron will be transferred. That implies one of the charge becomes minus E, whoever it gets the electron. Now this charge will be plus C. So that will be at higher potential. This will be at lower potential. Higher potential minus lower potential. I'm doing it. That is the potential difference. I'm just getting it. Okay. So don't do the work twice. Once you know that potential of one body is so much, other body is also same value, but with the minus sign. Difference is multiplying by 2. That's why I want you should not be doing this step. My dear students, please don't do this step. Once you know that, this is same. Minus of minus 1.6, that implies you have to add it up, same value. That implies you multiply by 2. So 3.2 into 10 minus 5, that implies 32 microvolt is the right answer. Okay. So agreeable to you, everybody. So I'll stop the sharing of the screen right now. Tomorrow we'll continue with the more questions on electrostatic potential as well as capacitors. So thank you so much for your patient listening. Let's meet tomorrow. Thank you.